the Johnson Wax Program with Fibber McGee and Molly. The makers of Johnson's Wax products for home and industry present Fibber McGee and Molly, written by Don Quinn and Phil Leslie, with music by the King's Men and Billy Mills Orchestra. I know a good many women who made a resolution a year ago and are still keeping it up. They resolved to practice protective housekeeping with genuine Johnson's Wax, and are they pleased. They tell me that not only are their homes lovelier than ever, but they've saved themselves hours of work, too. The fact is, things that are Johnson Wax do get lovelier with every application. I don't mean just floors, but many other things in your homes. Furniture, picture frames, ornaments, tables, doors, and refrigerators. All of these things have a lovely, lustrous, satin-smooth polish that adds immensely to the beauty of your home when they're protected with Johnson's Wax. You save yourself work, of course, because dirt and dust don't cling to a smooth, waxed surface so readily. Just a light dusting with a cloth restores their lovely luster in a jiffy. The year's only a week old. How about it? Let's resolve to have a lovelier, cleaner, healthier home in 1946 with Johnson's Wax. Kramer's drugstore in Wistful Vista always has an interesting window display about this time of year. It consists of a glass fishbowl full of navy beans, and you're supposed to guess how many. Now, if you don't think that's a pretty fascinating exhibit, get a load of the crowd on the sidewalk, which includes Mr. McGee of Fibber McGee and Molly.
I'll bet somebody could win first prize by betting the same number of beans that won last year. It could be far off.
They say Kramer puts a big rock in the middle of the bowl and piles of beans around it.
Who won the contest last year?
Kramer's mother-in-law.
My gosh, there ought to be some way to figure this thing out scientific.
Yeah, well, why don't you do it, McGee?
Oh, you think I can't, wise guy?
Yeah, well, I don't think you can do it.
Okay, by George, I'll show you. One side there, fellas. I got business. Yeah. Hey, Molly. Molly. Hey, Molly.
Get your voice down to a shriek, dearie. Huh? I'm right here. Heavenly days, what do you got?
A fishbowl and 10 pounds of beans.
Well, that's nice. If there's anything we need more than a diving helmet or a high-wheeled bicycle, it's a fishbowl and 10 pounds of beans.
Now, don't insult the quarterback till you know the score, Tootsie. I'm going to win Kramer's how many beans in the fishbowl contest.
Oh, for goodness sakes,
yes,
McGee,
sir.
Not another contest. You were just in one last week, remember?
And I won, too, diddle I?
Well, I will say it was nice of Mr. Kramer to let you bring his fishbowl and beans home with you. Or did you just steal them out of his window?
These are my very own.
Oh?
I purchased them. I'm going to count beans into this bowl till it's full and enter the total figure in the contest, and bingo, the McGees have just won a brand new radio.
Well, isn't that a little unethical, sweetheart? Aren't you supposed to guess how many beans in the bowl?
Ah, patah. Leave the guesswork to the peasants. I'm going to do this thing scientific. What have I got a brain for if it ain't to count beans into a bowl?
Well, you got me, dearie. That must be what it's for, all right.
Now, let's see. Help me clear off this table, Molly. I want to get to work right away. There. Now, I'll pour the beans out on the table.
Dear.
Pile of them.
You've taken enough beans out of circulation to reduce Boston to a crossroads village.
You'd be surprised to see how many beans this bowl will hold. Well, here we go, laughing and scratching. One, two, three.
Oh, wait a minute, McGee.
Huh?
I just happened to think, has Mr. Kramer a 99-year lease on that store? I'd hate to have him go out of business before you...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.